and then they're at liberty to rest and study and watch television, we can play snooker, and they're just available for call.
You can't tell by looking at a man what sort of farmer he'd make. You can't go by looks. You can only judge what sort of man makes a good fireman after he's been in the job and been tried and tested. We don't expect them to do miracles on the first few fires. In fact, I seem to remember my first few fires and I was really standing around lost. And it's after their few really smoky, nasty, hot jobs that you can tell whether a man has made the grade or not. He's the chap that wants to be on the branch, wants to be at the forefront, the chap that wants to be nearest the fire. Taking all these things into account, you would then say, well, he's a good lad, he'll be all right.
I'm putting it down to the kids, I think.
We give it a good wetting.
If it was a private house or an occupied building, obviously we've got to be very, very sparingly with the water.
In this case, we make pretty certain we're not going to come back to it. The children never get this started again anyway. Make it up.
Calling you, but they think, oh, he's taking a long time.
The classic example here, at Wheatstone
home road round the corner. It's a
It wouldn't take you 2 minutes to walk there. Now that job, three people lost their lives in that job because of the people. They stood outside and watched it burn, and it was about a quarter of an hour, wasn't it?
Where's the fire
bit? It was about a quarter of an hour before somebody decided to come round to the station and tell them that the place was burning. And when they eventually did get round there, of course it was far too late and the job was well out of hand. But had somebody come round as soon as they see it was burning, those people probably would have been alive today. And yet the fire brigade get the blame for that. Which is all wrong, isn't it?
When we arrive at a false alarm, the chap seems to think that it is a false alarm. There's no smoke coming from any of the windows. The street is all quiet, and the chaps look a bit listless and bored.
Hello, sir, I'm Mickey. Yes, I've got 8:30.
Can't
this
go? No, I think you came on. That's John.
Look like a Mickey again. Okay, we'll get him. If you hear anything apart from a Mickey, come back in
office.
Call box outside Kilburn's house. Ambulance also been called on.
That's all.
M2FM from Golf 271.
Ambulance also.
What's the matter? It's just a question of making sure that we've got the right address. Just checking, verifying the call, and sending all the appliances home and sending back our message, false alarm, and come back to the station. It's irritating because there's always a chance that somebody else could need us while we're out.
It's every time, and it's just sitting there quietly talking and what happens.